Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And if you're new here, my name is Esther Moffrey. In today's video is a very interesting video. I want to show you or share with you about support and resistance. You know, when you're trading and when you're beginning, support and resistance should be your best friend. This is the first thing that you should check whenever you open a chart. This is the first thing that even guides you on where either to take your profits, where the market is going, where to put your stop loss. This helps you in overall on your trades. So today I just want to show you a simple way of how to identify support and resistance, how even to put it in mind, how to keep it in mind, the key areas, because support and resistance are key areas where the money is and where things happens. So guys, if you're interested, continue watching, and if you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, kindly consider subscribing, like this video, give it a big thumbs up, and let's get down into the video. So guys, this is a 2-hour chart time frame, and the minute you open your chart, you want to know where is the key value, like where is the key area. And you'll determine this by identifying your resistance, identifying your support. For those who may not understand, resistance is where buyers try to push the market and maybe it is rejected. And support is where the sellers try to push the market and gets rejected. And maybe when it is like when the market is coming to the same position or the same place so many times, eventually either the sellers or the buyers may be able or may manage to push the market. So these are two very key areas that are very important when you identify them, and they can even help you to manage your trades, your take profit, your stop loss, to know how far can you push the market and etc. So the first thing that you need to identify is where the prices is reaching. So you'll just take this, you take this one, it's called a horizontal line. Then let's say, for example, if this market reached here and I place this market like that, if I place this this horizontal line in that way, the price, the buyers tried to push this market and it got rejected. They tried again, it broke, but still got rejected. And this is what we call fake breakout. If you don't know about fake breakout, I may do a video about it. Fake breakout is where the buyers think they have succeeded, but the price still goes, flips, and still continue on the downward trend. So this is a fake breakout. So it touched here once, it tried, but it flipped, so it didn't. So it called fake breakout. So it tried again. You can see here it tried. So this is the first time. Let me just put it like that. That's the first time. Then the second time, it's this one, because it tried, but it got rejected and it created a fake breakout. And many traders in this position, they lose money. Then the third time, you can see the third time, it touched another time. So if you're a good trader who is very observant, this should be your key area. You should be very attentive or very observant of this place. At this point, it tried, but it didn't touch. As you can see here, it didn't touch. So it was the buyers tried to push this market, but they didn't. Then this is 1, 2, 3. The fourth time it didn't reach. The fifth time it reached. So I'm just showing you how many times this key area it has been touched. Then how many times? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The fifth time, and then the sixth time. And then it broke through, came retested again. It broke, it broke, and then it started to retest the same place. And then the market started retesting the same place. And then it started to retest now to, you see this position, now it is using the same resistance as support. Now you understand this value or this key area is very, very important. Price breaks this point. You see, it has broken this place. You need to be quick. You need to be quick. You need to be very, very quick to ask yourself, where is the price going? Where is this price? Yes, it has broken the key value, that the key area. It was first our resistance. It became our support. It became now again our support. Remember, it started as resistance. So you ask yourself, if the market breaks here, where is it going? It will go to the next support. You see this support? It will go here. So we create another support. It is like we are creating another support. So we are just attentive of this. And if I can take my horizontal line and try to extend it, we can see the price had touched previously on this area. So if I bring it here, you can see from this point, it touched once. It came here, reacted, it didn't touch. Then came here, touched. So what happens here? If you're a good trader and you're observing support and resistance, this is a place that you should come and really observe. So what I can do here is to observe if the markets, what will happen on this place. So you just put a box like that. Remember, this low has, now we are going to market structure. Remember, support and resistance cannot be traded on their own. You need now correlation of other things to support what you're doing. Remember, like I told you on the other video, how to know if you want to buy or you want to sell. I told you, you need to understand what is the trend. So the first thing, this trend is a downward trend, because what is happening is that the price is moving from here all the way here. So the price is like, it is moving from here to here. So this is a downward trend. It's like that. Then it has hit the previous support and the previous support. So what we are putting in mind, this place is a key area, is another support. So we are very attentive. You can't sell here. Don't make a mistake and try to sell on this place. What you can try to see, if this market will come up, if it will come up to touch or to retest this place. You see this support that was, this resistance that became support, if it come and retest, like a pullback, if it comes and retest, now we can enter our sell position. But before it has retested this place, don't dare to put a sell position. Guys, that's how we use our sell, our support, our resistance. Pay attention and you'll see support and resistance. They are very, very, very useful. Guys, I hope you have understood. Resistance and support is very, 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 very important. And it happens always. You can see here, this was a support, this was support. And this was 1st October, it came to react on 14th October. So it doesn't matter, like it will hit 1st October, then 2nd October, the same place. It can take time, but it will repeat itself and it will use the same place where the market reached. So eventually, this market, this price, if it retests at this place, let's say if I can be told to predict this market, I can put a short here. Let's say the market has retested. I'll put my short here. Just put my stop loss. And then I put my take profit exactly at that time. That's how I would do that trade. So this is how we do a support and resistance. It's very easy. Very, very easy. And you just need to master your areas and you will know how to you'll know how to use support, you know how to use the resistance, you'll be able to get entry on good trades, you'll be able to avoid fake breakouts, you'll be able to avoid getting stopped out. So guys, I hope you have learned about support resistance. If you have any question, comment down below. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, and if you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, kindly consider subscribing, because I'll be sharing a lot of Forex trading videos. Until next time, bye bye. Love you.